up there?
Outside.
Huh?
Outside.
And down. So how do we get to that pitch? Okay, so this one is going to take longer to learn. So the way you can practice it is, you have a tee at home that you work off of?
Yes, well, I go to the batting cage every day.
Okay. Okay, so they probably won't have a low tee. I have one, but I left it at home. So instead of, if you don't have a low tee, what you do is you get a, just get a Gatorade bottle and put the ball in the Gatorade bottle. And practice going down to hit the ball. And you want to keep it off the ground, okay? For most guys, it takes them longer to learn that move. You can fall and be landing on your heels. Okay? You got to stay on the ball with your, all of your feet. Okay, so try to do this. Make contact with the arms bent. Try to keep your knees bent the whole time. Okay, while we're hitting. Try to keep your knees bent the whole time when you swing. Even on the waist high pitch. Okay, good. Head's going back, trying to get extended. Straighten your knees up, your head's going to fly up. Because you're doing it artificially. Okay? You're not letting your hips straighten your knees, you're doing that. Okay? Because you're out of sequence, you're trying to generate that energy, and you don't have any energy left. So you're doing this, you straighten it up. Okay? If you start from the ground this way, okay, you won't lock out your knees so early. Okay, again, you keep trying. That ball's belt high, you keep trying to get extended. At contact. Don't extend at contact. Don't extend at contact. The arm is bent. Alright. And you're landing with your heel down. Heel's gotta be up. Land on the ball, you're like you're stepping on the eggshell. When your front foot lands, your heel should be up. Okay, that's gonna allow you to adjust to the off-speed pitch. See that? See how you took that pitch? Okay, your top half went and your bottom half didn't move. So you're out of sequence. So I'll send you a drill for that too. You can work on that. So when you start using your legs, you're gonna start hitting home runs. Point blank. Okay, because you got plenty of bat speed, but you're using all arms right now to swing the bat. Okay? Arm swing. Okay, you gotta let your legs do the work. Now you're stomping your foot down. So that means your head's moving. So keep your head over your spine. Land on the ball of your foot. The faster your body moves, the slower your bat's going to move. Thank you.
because I'm trying to decide, get him to, I'm trying to get him to figure out what's going to be his game back, because you don't play many wood bats.
I mean, it's that's like a personal thing.
Yeah.
That when I played, I had four different models I used to use. It just depends on how I was feeling that day. So.
Right. Yeah, I just want him to.
And then, you know, plus with, you know, with kids, they're still growing, so. Mm.
They have one bat
today,
Should you have done on that pitch?
Waited a little bit longer.
How?
By getting like, getting the athletic.
Sinking into your legs. Oh. All you gotta do is just sink down into your legs. That's it. Pitch, you get up in the air pretty easily, but as soon as I get it up around your thighs, you beat it to the ground. So you keep trying to get it extended instead of staying connected and turning. You want to hit the ball with the arm and bent, so you have to stay in your posture. Okay? Let your head go back or to the side. You're waiting. Okay, again, your back knees gotta stay inside your foot. Don't let it get on top of your foot. Keep your back knee inside your foot.
Hit it on top of it.
Right, because you keep throwing your hands at the ball. Instead of just using your legs and just turn. Okay, so here, I'll show you a drill you can do at home. Grab it to you. Two drills.
Just put it right there on the inside corner.
You can do is okay. So when you're hitting, the first move, your first move of your bat is this. Bat goes flat. All right. So you start with the bat right here, without moving your arms. Right. Just turn. See that? Never move my arms. So that's one drill you can do. Without moving your arms. See how quickly you can get the bat to the ball. All right. The other drill you can do. So you want to start it out either on the inside part or the inside corner. When you get good at it, you can put it on this line. Alright, so put the ball in the inside corner. So this is the foul line. You want to pull the ball down the line in the air. Okay? So it just, that's all you want to do. Let's do a couple of those. So pull it down the line in the air. Where you normally stand at the plate. Okay. Down the line that way. Well, see those bars over there? That's where it needs to go. Don't cheat. Alright, so that's the drill you can do at home. And the only way you're going to be able to do that is you got to stay connected and turn. Okay, the minute you start doing this, then go mess it up. Alright. So do the other drill first and then do that one. Get off that back leg. So Aaron Judge, what do you think the most home runs he had in the minor leagues in one season?
Yeah, how many?
In his minor league career, what was his highest total? What do you think? Because remember, his rookie year, he had 54. Right. So how many do you think he hit in the minor leagues in one year?
Like 69.
In one season? His highest amount was 19. Okay, you know why it was so low? Because he couldn't pull the ball in the air. He didn't learn how to pull the ball in the air until he got to the big league. Even though a lot of his home runs were right center, but his every big leaguer, when their home run totals go up, it goes up because they learn how to pull the ball in the air. Okay, so that's one thing you got to learn to do, because in the big league, if you can't pull the ball, that's how they're going to pick you, until you can prove that you can pull it. Which you can pull it, but you got to pull it in the air. You got to start pulling in the air eventually. And yeah, keep those arms bent. Okay, use your legs, not your shoulders. Legs, not your shoulders. And you hover it on that back leg again. Got to keep moving. Ball's not there, you just sink into your legs. Ball's gonna get there. Okay? You can't hover on the back legs. Because if I'm pitching, if I'm pitch catching, because I was a catcher, and I see you doing that, okay, I either gonna throw you something really slow out in front, or I'm gonna bust you in on your hands, and you're not gonna be able to catch up. Once you stop. I'm not throwing you any curveballs. There's no reason to stay back. You only get ready for a fastball. Okay, you know what Max Scherzer is, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So if Max Scherzer throws you one of his good sliders, what are you going to do with it?
Hold on. I'm gonna try to hit it out.
You're not gonna do anything with it. That's why it's a good slider.
Well, what? Maybe.
No, not no maybe. If he throws you a good slider, or Justin Verlander throws you a good slider, or Clayton Kershaw throws you a good curveball, you you are not going to hit. Okay, you're not going to make a living off anybody that can, that throws a pitch like that. Okay, but you, the way you're thinking is, you think you're trying to stay back so that you can hit that pitch. Meanwhile, you keep missing this pitch that you should be hitting. You understand? Okay. Stop worrying about a pitch that you can't hit. Okay. Get yourself ready for a pitch that you can't hit. Okay. Now, you're not going to face a whole lot of max surgeons. Most of the guys that you face are going to be missing balls right somewhere in here, even with their breaking balls. You don't need to look for that pitch to be able to hit it. Okay. You're looking for a pitch that you can't hit, and you're making yourself not able to hit a pitch that you can't hit. Okay? Or just focus on what you can hit, what you're supposed to hit. You're not supposed to hit nasty breaking ball. You're not going to make a living doing that. Okay? But not everybody can make that pitch every time. Most of the time, especially the level you're playing at right now, most of the breaking ball is going to be right here. You don't need to look for it to be able to hit it. You just need to be in an athletic position. Okay? Play basketball for fun?
Yes.
Okay. So right now, okay, we're playing basketball. You got the ball, you dribble on the court. Keep it back. Okay, you dribble up court, I'm coming up to guard you. All right? What are you going to do after you stop lot? With the basketball, what are you going to do? You're going to go right by me, right? Okay, you know what I just did? I just imitated your batting stance. You just laughed at yourself. Okay? So what position should I be in to guard you? Right. Why should I be in that position? Why do I need to be in that position? Because I don't know which way you're going, right? So I need to go left, right, forward, or backward. Okay? So what did I do? What was the first thing I did today? What was the first thing we talked about?
Having
balance.
Yeah,
balance. Okay? What was my balance position? Right here. Same position I'm in to guard you on basketball. Okay? Same position you need to be in when you're hitting. Okay? Because you don't know what pitch is coming. This is what allows you to adjust to different pitches. Not this. This is not an athletic position. Nobody does this in any sport except baseball. This is the only sport they teach this in. Okay? This is not an athletic position. This is not a hitting position. Okay? This is a hitting position. This is the position you got to get to when you take your stride, okay? Ball's not there, sink into your legs, no problem, okay? But if you do this, you're not going to hit the fastball or the breaking ball, not a good one, right?
You think he's starting too early, or?
Huh?
You think he's starting too early, or it just?
He'll figure that part out.
Okay.
But again, if you start early, that's why you sink into your legs. Because
mm-hmm.
if you're looking for a fastball and he throws you a curveball, you're starting too early. So you have to adjust.
Yeah.
Okay. Once he gets you, because timing is a brain function. Okay. Once he gets used to doing it correctly, then he'll get the timing. Okay. You can adjust if you're early. You can't adjust if you're late.
Right.
Pull your eyes back away from the ball, then you're gonna have to throw your arms back out to get to the ball. You gotta stay in your posture, keep your eyes close to the ball. So a friend of mine who used to coach with me, he's the national hitting director for the Mets. Okay. The Mets have a thing, every kid that they scout. Okay, first of all, before they draft the guy, he has to approve their swing. But they have this thing where they check everybody they look considering the draft, they check their ground ball ratio. Okay, you know what that is?
Uh
How many times you hit ground ball?
Right. How many times you hit the ball on the ground? If their ratio is too high, they won't draft it. That's the Mets. And I'm sure other teams have that too. But he told me this personally, so I saw him know the Mets do it for sure. If the hitter they're looking at, draft, if they're scouting, if this ground ball ratio is too high, they will not draft it. No matter what else he can do on the field. It's crazy, right?
Yeah.
So you're eliminating yourself from at least one team with all the ground balls. What time you guys play tomorrow?
10.
Just one game?
10 and 2:40.
10
and
2:40?
At a high school.
So I got a 4:00 tomorrow. So if you want to come back after your game, your second game, you hit some more if you want.
Okay. Yeah.
Why are you falling back? Because your head's going that way. You gotta keep your chest out over your knees and your head over your spine. Then turn around your spine. Alright, you got about 10 more. Good. Don't wait, don't hover. Keep moving. Okay, so if you're gonna do a leg kick, you gotta learn to control your body. You know Jamar Johnson?
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
Okay, so I hit with Tamar pretty much every day. So he does a leg kick. Okay, but when he does it, he doesn't stop moving. Okay, he moves slow because he's able to control his body, but he doesn't stop moving when he kicks his leg up. Yeah. Hips gotta go first. Sink into your legs. This is gonna happen. You know, somebody throws you a change up or a curveball, whatever. It's not there yet. Just sink into your leg. You keep rushing your body. You keep rushing your body trying to get the ball. You gotta slow everything down. Too. If your feet get close together, it's going to raise your head up as well. Okay, so you have to maintain your stride distance, your distance, your stride level. Most guys hit the low pitch on the ground, you hit the high pitch on the ground. The low pitch, you drive it up in the air. So that means you're a low ball hitter, obviously. But we gotta make sure we hit this pitch correctly.